Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In this video, we are going to discuss high and low voltage LD MOSFET design and as well as cross-sectional view and as well as layout styles. So this is the introduction video about this LD MOSFET. I am planning to upload so many videos regarding the LD MOSFET in future. Let's start the video. Before we are going to understand the LD MOSFET, so I just wanted to tell you what is mean by LD MOS. So LD MOSFET is the kind of MOSFET where they are using for high voltage applications. So initially, like typical MOSFETs have some voltage ratings like 1.2 volt to 5 volt or up to 12 volt. So we have some voltage ratings. The maximum voltage rating is 12. The maximum, like typical MOSFETs will work on up to 12 volt. But the LD MOSFET is the MOSFET where they are going to use it for a high voltage applications such as like automotives and amplifiers and microwave amplifiers and as well as audio amplifiers. So where they need a high voltage operating devices, so in that particular places they will use LD MOSFET. So lateral diffused metal oxide semiconductor is the full form of LD MOSFET. So the application of the LD MOSFET, as we already discussed, like automotives and then amplifiers, high power amplifiers, microwave amplifiers, RF amplifiers and power amplifiers. We have a different foundries which they are fabricating LD MOSFET. The primary foundry, most of the projects and most of the, you know, like companies are using TSMC foundry. And apart from that, we have L foundry and then Tower Semiconductor, and Global Foundry is the leading manufacturer company. And then we have, you know, so on, we have different types of manufacturing companies that they are fabricating the LD MOSFET in their own fabrication way. And LD MOSFET having the voltage rating of, initial voltage rating is 1.8 volt, the maximum voltage rating is 70 volt. So even more than 70 voltage, we have a, you know, like special devices are available which can work up to like 120 voltage or up to 90 to 120 voltage rating. So even though they have 90 to 120 voltage devices with LD MOSFET, so at present they are not using like 90 to 120 voltage devices because, you know, like most of the companies are trying to reduce the voltage rating in order to improve the battery backup of the devices and in order to extend the battery life. They are trying to reduce, but whereas some particular places they need to operate with a higher voltage rating. If there is a need, then they will go for the higher voltage rating devices. In our design, so whatever we are going to discuss in the future about this LD MOSFET, so this is purely based on the TSMC foundry technique, and what we are going to use LD MOSFET with 180 nanometer technology. So in this 180 nanometer technology, so we are using shallow trench isolation method. Okay, so STA is using in our design, and then we have a retro 4-well CMOS technology, so which is under 100 wafer fabrication. So we have a three types of, you know, wafer fabrication techniques are there. So one is like 100 and 110 and 101 something is there. So we have three different types of CMOS, you know, like access technologies. So these how the fabrication of the wafer is take place, so it depends this number, like 110 or 100 something like that. We have different types, and in this LD MOSFET technology we are going to use low sheet resistance, which is weld resistance. So because if you have a low weld resistance, automatically your latch up behavior will enhanced. Okay, so there is a possibilities of latch up in all the circuit. If there is a lower sheet resistance, your latch up problems will, as you know, as low as possible, the problem will reduce. And then we have a N buried layer process is also available with this LD MOSFET techniques. So we have a 4 LV wells. LV is nothing but low wells, okay, low voltage wells. And we have a 2 high voltage wells, and as well as N buried layer is there. And apart from that, we have a deep N well technique also is there available in this LD MOSFET technology. And in our LD MOSFET technology, we have a single and double gate oxide process. So So usually they will use single, you know, like gate oxide process in the typical MOSFET, but whereas in our LD MOSFET, since we have a high voltage, you know, like voltage rating devices, so we are going to use double gate oxide process. Okay, so here we have a voltage rating with respect to the gate oxide. If we have a single gate oxide devices, so from 5 voltage to 70 voltage devices are available. If you have a double gated gate oxide devices, then 1.8 voltage to 70 voltage devices are available. And then same 5 voltage to 12 voltage devices are also available. So these two devices are core and IO devices. The top one is like our this is our core devices, and bottom whatever we have, this is our IO devices. Both devices are different devices, and we have N plus and P plus poly gated. And in our design, they are going to use self-aligned, you know, like source and drain formations. So they are using self-aligned contact formation and self-aligned process for the source and gate, and as well as drain formation. And silicide is necessary to short N plus and P plus gate in this technology, because silicidation is a process. Okay, so silicidation will give, you know, like silicide, if you applied silicidation layer, so that will try to reduce your resistance of any metal. If you are not using silicided, if it is unsilicided, then the resistance values of the, you know, like well or whatever it is there, okay, so that will be higher. So and then we have unsilicided poly and as well as OD resistors are available in our design. So here I have mentioned silicidation protection. So okay, silicidization is need additional mask. If you want to fabricate silicidization layer, we need one more additional mask is mandatory. So the mask name is called RPO layer. That is nothing but our resistor protective layer. So this RPO layer will prevent the formation of the active area, which means the silicidation formation. So this RPO layer will prevent. Then we have a types of resistor with our design, like we have a N plus and OD well resistance and poly resistance, so on. I have mentioned, you know, like number of 8 types of resistors are available. So these 8 types of resistors are available in our design. Okay, so then we look into the cross-sectional view of the LD MOSFET. So this is the typical LD MOSFET, you know, like top level view. So whereas the red color layer, so this particular portion entirely is filled with poly layer, and this side also, this is completely filled with poly layer. So this is our poly layer. So on, we have a source terminal and as well as our drain terminal. So this is our source terminal, and this is our drain terminal, and this is our one more source terminal. So this is nothing but our source, and this is nothing but our drain, and this is nothing but our one more source. So source and drain and as well as source. Then in our fabrication technology, since you know people try to understand with the top level view, if not we can try to understand with this cross-sectional view also. So generally the cross-sectional view, it's an easy way to understand LD MOSFET, you know, the design and design method. So we have a poly gate, so we have a N plus region, that is our drain, and we have one more N plus and N plus that is used for our, so you know, like one more source terminal, and then we have one more poly gate and one more N plus region. So we have a drain and as well as we have a source and we have a drain terminal. Apart from that, we have a HV-NVL. So HV-NVL is nothing but high voltage NVL, whereas if the devices are working with higher voltage ratings, if more than 12 volt to 70 volt, what we discussed earlier, if the devices are working in higher voltage rating, then this HV-NVL is needed. If the devices are working with lower voltage rating, then LV-NVL, so low voltage NVL, they will use it. And then buried layer process. So buried layer process is completely, you know, like it's a different kind of manufacturing process of an industry. So N buried layer is a layer, is nothing but one more deep N-well layer. Okay, so deep N-well having some voltage, you know, limitations. For example, there are certain foundries, TSMC foundry, they have a voltage limitations like 5 voltage to 12 voltage. So which means the reverse breakdown voltage, or you know, the breakdown voltage of the deep N-well diode will be 5 voltage to 12 voltage. But here the voltage rating what the devices are using, we are using like more than 70 voltage. So if you are using 70 voltage devices, then deep N-well will not, you know, sufficient, or it won't work for this higher voltage rating. So if it was the case, then we have to go for the buried layer process. So buried layer process is the diode formation exactly like deep N-well, but this will give higher breakdown, junction breakdown, like more than 70 volt junction breakdowns will be there. So this is our P substrate, for example, consider. So this is our piece of state layer. So this is our global substrate. On top of the piece of state layer, the foundries are going to fabricate like N-buried layer. So after fabrication of this N-buried layer, they are going to fabricate HVN well. So that is our local well. Then whatever N plus layer is needed, whatever P plus layer is needed, and we'll discuss about this SH underscore N and this HVPB. So this SHPB. So regarding these, you know, particular layers name, we'll discuss in future. But so these are all like one more you know, like masking process, and this SH underscore N and this HVPB, these are like one more different, you know, like layers which they are using for higher voltage purpose. So apart from that, so left and right we have a STI layer. So hope you can able to see this STI and these TSTI. So this is our substrate. Substrate is nothing but our guard ring. So guard ring is like P plus guard ring we have added, and which is connected to substrate. And this is our global substrate. Left and right we have a body contact, and then we have a STI. So which means like our guard ring is isolated from the STI. Okay, so the STI is giving more you know, like trench kind of techniques to prevent latch up, to prevent leakage to the substrate. Okay, so then we have a N plus region, that is our source drain, and as well as another you know, like source or drain region can be fabricated with this N plus formation. Okay, so this is our typical LD MOSFET devices. And then we'll come to the next one more type of LD MOSFET devices. So suppose if we are using more than 90 volt, okay, so consider we are using more than 90 volt. So what happened? See, even though this N-buried layer is having higher reverse breakdown voltage or like junction breakdown voltage, whatever it is, if you are going for the certain voltage limitations, like more than, you know, like 300 voltage devices are also available. Suppose if you are going for higher voltage rating, so in that case, we need a trenching technology that is called a deep trench. So that is nothing but N-buried layer with a DT. DT is nothing but deep trench technology. So this is our trench. So hope you can able to see. So this is our trench technique. Whereas our STI will be fabricated, so underneath of the STI they will create a trench. Okay, though this is also like one more insulated layer. So this trench will prevent like leakage from the substrate to the next layer. So from so from this HVNVL to the local substrate, which is our P substrate. So from here to here, this HVNVL to the P substrate. So this deep trench will give like insulator layer. So this is like a passivation layer or else insulator layer. So this insulator layer will give will prevent leakage from the HVNVL to the P substrate, and as well as N-buried layer to the P substrate. Okay, so these deep trench technology also available in the normal LD MOSFET fabrication and process. And apart from that, everything is remain same. So whatever we have discussed in the previous HVNVL, all the layers are remain same. Apart from that, we have a one more external fabrication step is nothing but our deep trench technology. So in this LD MOSFET technology, we have a deep NVL also we can implement in this LD MOSFET technology. Along with N-buried layer, we can also add deep NVL. So if the deep NVL device has to fabricate, if it was the case, then you know this is how the structure will be there, the cross-sectional view and as well as the top level view of the layout. So this is how the structure will be there for deep NVL layer. So initially for deep NVL layer, so just consider this is our device. Initially our P substrate will be fabricated, that is our P minus substrate, that is our local substrate. On top of the P substrate layer, we have an N-buried layer. So these N-buried layer connection will try to connect to HVNVL, because these N-buried layer voltage rating is very high, like 70 voltage to 90 voltage to 300 voltage. Okay, so we can go for you know, like higher voltage rating. So in this N-buried layer will try to connect. So they are going to do some implantation called HVNVL. So here HVNVL implantation will be added for this N-buried layer. So they will add HVNVL layer. So after this HVNVL layer, this HVNVL layer will be connected to N plus region. So this is our N-buried layer terminal. Okay, so this is our N-buried layer terminal. So next, on top of that N-buried layer, we have a deep NVL layer. Okay, so deep NVL they can add, or else you know deep PVL also they can add. Okay, so they have so many different types of fabricational methods are there. So they will add deep NVL. If not, they can go for deep PVL also. So both the techniques they can implement. Suppose if they want to fabricate, so this is how the fabricational steps will be there. Okay, so then the dependable layer will be connected to the P plus terminal. So this P plus terminal is our dependable terminal. Then we have a local devices inside the structure. We have a local devices like our source, gate, drain, everything will be fabricated under, you know, like inside of our dependable layer. So this cross-sectional view is like same the representation of the top level. So in top level, outside ring, whatever we have, this ring is our P minus ring. So this is our P minus ring. So which is our global substrate. So next to that, we have a one more ring here, the green color one. This is our next ring. So this is our N-buried layer. Okay, so this is our NBL ring. Then we have internally, we have one more layer is available. So this is our local bulk, like N well, P well, whatever it is, we can go for the local bulk. So this P well, and then this N buried layer. So we have a three different types of rings will be available. So this is our first ring, and this is our second ring, and this is our third ring. So if they want to fabricate N buried layer process with deep N well, so we need these three different types of guard ring should be added in the devices. Apart from that, we have a one more ring also. So that is our local substrate ring. Okay, so that is our local bulk connection ring. So totally, so we can able to fabricate like four rings are mandatory to fabricate N-buried layer process with the deep N-well technology. So this is like an introduction video and so basic explanation of cross-sectional view on the LD MOSFET.
I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.